Hi Math54. This is the video for lesson 107, which is located in your book on page 495. This lesson is scheduled for April 6th. And as a reminder, since April 6th is a Monday, your homework for week 9, your assignment sheet for week 9, is due today. Have your parents sign it and fill it all in. And they can email it to me or text it to me or attach it to the Google Classroom assignment in there. So, our time test for today is time test B, which is located on page 212 in your test and worksheet booklet. So you can take your time to do that and have your parents grade that. Today we're gonna be on lesson 107, we're gonna be working with adding and subtracting fractions. So we're gonna do a quick little reminder on fractions here. I have my top number is called a numerator. My bottom number is called a denominator. We always review this. I know you're probably thinking, why is she reviewing that again? But I wanna make sure everybody has that solid in their brain. Denominator we remember because denominator starts with D. For down, denominator, down, D. So we're going to be adding fractions that have the word is common denominator. The common denominator, that's a big term, but what that really means is that we're gonna be adding fractions that have the same denominator. So don't let common denominator be a scary term for you, it's not. Okay, so let's look at some examples of that with our fraction pieces. I have 1/3 as my fraction piece here. And if I'm going to add, and I want to add 1 more third, 1/3 plus 1/3 equals 2/3. Okay, so if I want to look at that in a different way, I'm gonna be showing you multiple different ways to make sure that it makes sense. So this is one way to look at it in these little fraction pieces and say 1/3 plus 1/3 equals 2/3. Another way you can look at it is back over here on my sheet of paper, I have drawn our circles and divided it into thirds. 1, 2, 3 pieces, so each piece is 1/3. And I'm gonna color in 1/3 of this one. And I'm gonna color in 1/3 of this piece. So if I was to write this as a fraction, how much of this circle is shaded? The answer would be 1/3 of that circle is shaded. And then if I wanna look at this circle and say how much of this circle is shaded, one piece out of the total of 3 pieces, 1, 2, 3, is shaded. And then I can add them together. So if I have, when I add fractions that have a common denominator, in these, both of these fractions, 3 is my denominator. 3 is called a common denominator because it is the same denominator in both fractions, okay? So when I add these fractions, I just move that denominator over to my sum, and it becomes a 3 because it's common. They're this exact same, so I keep that. Then I add my numerators. 1 plus 1 is 2. So my answer, if I put it up here, I drew my arrow the wrong way, is 2/3. Okay, so it's the same answer we got when we did our fraction pieces of 1/3 plus 1/3 equals 2/3. This is what it looks like as an addition sentence. 1/3 plus 1/3 equals 2/3. You keep your common denominator across all the way and you add your numerators, okay? So let's look at some more options. We can also subtract fractions. Now if you look, these fractions also happen to have the same denominator. Both denominators are 3. So it's called a common denominator. You'll go ahead, just like we did in addition, and you'll move that denominator over. It's not changing because it's the same. Okay? So then all you have to do is subtract your numerators. 2 minus 1 is 1. And there is your answer. Okay? If I do that in fraction pieces, let's just go ahead and do that. If I have, let me put these side by side so you can see. Okay, so you can see them both together. There is the subtraction sentence. Here are the pieces, okay? Make sure I'm on. Okay, good. I'm on the video. 2/3, which is what I have, 1, 2, 2/3, minus 1/3, so I'm gonna take away 1/3, and I have left 1/3, okay? So that's how I show it on my fraction pieces, if you wanna use your fraction pieces for this. Okay, so now I can come down to some more examples. I'm still doing the same thing. The difference is these are mixed numbers. This is an addition problem, mixed numbers, and this is a subtraction problem of mixed numbers. When I look at it, I notice something about it. I notice my denominators are the same. So I have common denominators. So I can add and subtract in the same way. But the first thing that you want to do when you have a mixed number or any fraction like this is to, especially mixed numbers, it makes it much clearer if you will write it vertical. So 5 3/8, I'm just taking my same problem and writing it vertical, up and down. Plus 1 2/8, okay? So let's do that and see. Now, the same rule applies. My denominators are the same, so they're not gonna change. I'm gonna just bring that denominator down as an 8. Then 3 + 2 is 5. So that's my numerator, just like if these guys weren't here. You're just kind of almost pretending those whole numbers aren't there yet. And you're just working with your fraction piece to start with. So work with that fraction piece to start with. Then we can move over and now we can work with just our whole numbers. So 5 + 1 is 6. So my answer is 6 5/8. So you work each piece individually. So let's look at this same problem, but now it's changed into a subtraction problem. Again, I'm gonna start out by writing it vertically because it's so much easier to see. Okay, I look to my denominators. When I look to my denominators, they both are 8, so they are a common denominator. So again, I'm gonna just bring that straight down. I'm pretending that like I could almost cover up. In fact, I will. I'll cover up that 5 and 1 because we're not dealing with that yet. Okay? Except I need to know that I am subtracting. That's all I need from over here. So 3 - 2 is 1. So now I've finished the fraction side of it. So now I can work with the whole number side of it. And the whole number side of it, I cover up the piece I don't need over here now. 5 - 1 is 4. So then I look at my mixed number and see that it looks right. So that's my answer. Okay, so let's look at some more examples. This is a word problem. In a race, Mark rode a bike 1/2 miles and ran 2.5 miles. How far did he bike and run? That word "and" right there tells us when you have two things that you are combining, you're putting them together with "and." How far did he bike is one piece and run. So we're gonna be adding bike to run. The two pieces are gonna come together because of the word and. Okay, so let's look at, let's write down, I always like to write down what's given first in a word problem. So how far did he bike? In a race, Mark rode a bike 7.5 miles. 7.5 miles. That's just an abbreviation for miles. And then I need to know how far did he run? And ran 2.5 miles. Okay. How far did he bike and run? So I know I have to add these guys together. Okay, so I'm gonna add, and I already have it vertical since I wrote it down that way. So I'm just gonna now work with what I've found in my problem. Okay, I look to my denominators, and both of my denominators are twos, so I have a common denominator. So I'm just gonna bring that down. Okay, I'm gonna cover up my other side so I know all I'm dealing with right now is my fraction piece of my mixed number. And I know I'm adding, so 1 plus 1 is 2. So then I'm gonna swap over and I'm gonna deal with my whole numbers. 7 plus 2 is 9. Now, I'm gonna look at my mixed number. I have 9 and 2/2. That doesn't work as a mixed number, does it? So I need to fix it. So I know that 9's okay. So I'm gonna move that down as is. But when I look at the fraction of 2/2, I know that any fraction where the numerator and the denominator are the same number, or it equals 1. So I also know this bar means the same as divide. So 2/2 is 1. So that becomes 1, and then I have to add them together because I'm taking the 9 piece and I'm taking the fraction piece and putting them together to equal 10 miles. That was the total he ran. Okay, so let me go back over that a little bit again. So I had the 9 and 2/2 or 2/2, which I know that 2/2 doesn't look like a regular mix. 9 and 2/2 doesn't look like a regular mixed fraction because this is an improper fraction, right? Because the numerator is usually smaller than the denominator, but they're equal here. So I have to do something with that. And if I had a circle and I cut it in half, because I have 2 pieces, so I'm cutting it in 2 pieces. And then, remember, I shade how many? I shade 2 of the 2 pieces. I essentially have 1 whole circle shaded. So I can, it's like saying 9 plus 1, which is 10. Okay? So your practice problems for this lesson are on page 497. So when you get to your practice problems, we've done an example that's similar to every one of these. The only example that I haven't done an exact one would be this one right here. So let's work on it together. So this one is taking words and turning it in to numbers and then solving the problem. So take the words, first step, take the words and turn it into numbers. Second step, solve the problem. So there's 2 steps to letter M. So let's look at it. Letter M, how much is 3/8 plus 4/8? So I need to look at just the piece that's talking about numbers. 3/8 is a fraction. So on letter M, my first piece I need to write down is 3/8. So I need to, if I have eighths, I know my denominator is 8. and then the number 3. So I have 3 eighths. Plus, and here I have 4 eighths. So again, my denominator would be 8. And my numerator, 4 eighths. So then I have a problem I can solve. So then it'll be just like the other problems. So that was the only one that was a little bit trickier than any of the examples I did. So you can do your practice problems and you can have your parents check them, and there'll be a video coming for lesson 108. Bye.